Now, federal parliament has delivered an historic apology to victims of bullying, harassment and sexual assault within Commonwealth workplaces.
The Prime Minister apologised specifically to former staffer Brittany Higgins, whose allegation of rape in a ministerial office in 2019 led to a review of parliamentary workplace culture.
I am sorry. We are sorry. I'm sorry to Ms. Higgins for the terrible things that took place here. And the place that should have been a place of safety and contribution turned out to be a nightmare. But I'm sorry for far more than that, for all of those who came before Ms. Higgins and endured the same, but she had the courage to stand.
Former Liberal-turned-Independent MP Julia Banks was subjected to that toxic work culture within Parliament and joins us now from Canberra. It's good to see you, Julia. Thanks for joining us. What did you make of
thanks for having me,
the
Sarah
Prime Minister's apology? What did you make of that apology yesterday?
What I made of it is what I suspect a lot of Australians made of it, which is more words and no action. We have seen a year since it's almost a year since Brittany Higgins told her harrowing story, and not just her harrowing story, but the 2 years prior to her telling that story. And out of that, we have seen any number of inquiries, task forces, announcements, speeches, statements. We haven't seen action. Actions speak louder than words.
Most definitely. Julia, do you feel the apology will change anything? I mean, do these men really understand the power issues at the foundation of bullying and sexual assault?
I don't actually think the statement will change anything. What will change things, Tristan, is action, is real action. Like, the government have had so many opportunities during the last year. For example, the Respect at Work submission by Kate Jenkins, which was languishing on Christian Porter's desk, and one of the key recommendations of that was to impose the positive duty on employers for workplaces across Australia, and that could have included Parliament, but what did they do with that? They shelved it. They just put it under the carpet and didn't impose that recommendation. That recommendation would be signature law reform. It would literally, that is what will change things. We need exceptional action and change from this government, and we've seen nothing but the reverse. But a litany of task forces, inquiries, ducking and weaving, and you know, reports, all of that, and statements. And as I said, we need real action, real law reform, real change.
It was brave of these women to stand there or sit there and look people in the eye as they were apologised to. Apparently, Brittany Higgins was in tears as she left. Have you spoken to her since? Is she doing okay?
I haven't spoken to Brittany since yesterday. I've spoken to her, obviously, throughout the last 12 months. And yes, their bravery and courage of those women is absolutely outstanding. But, you know, as a country and the people in power, particularly the men in power, they have to realise that we've got to stop putting this burden on women having to tell these uncomfortable stories. We just have to stop doing that. And the only way to do that is to implement effective and real change. And that is, for some reason, what the Morrison government does not want to do. And they have demonstrated nothing but their tenure and incompetence and mismanagement of this crisis, which it has been a crisis. It's been Australia's Me Too reckoning in 2021, and they have done nothing to properly address it.
Yeah. I found the apology quite genuine yesterday. But what is your personal experience of Scott Morrison?
Well, my personal experience of Scott Morrison is the same as many in his party. He's not a man that can be trusted, and that is my personal experience. And I know I'm not alone. That the whole country knows I'm not alone in that. We've seen that distrust come through in his attempts to cover up this whole situation with regard to the treatment of women across the parliament. And we've seen in in his mismanagement, all we have seen is the lack of respect for the safety, for the respect of women and for the equity of women in Australia, particularly in Australia's workplaces.
In those leaked texts from, allegedly, Gladys Berejiklian, she referred to the Prime Minister as a horrible, horrible person. I think you've referred to the Prime Minister as a menacing type of wallpaper before. Is that the kind of person that can make this kind of change, do you think, within Parliament House?
Well, he's one thing that Scott Morrison is very good at, and that is at controlling the narrative. He loves to control the narrative. He's a very good campaigner and a very good tactician in that space. But I think he's come across a force that is really has to be reckoned with, and that is that women and men are standing up and speaking out. We need to, you know, we basically, these young women, Grace Tame and Brittany Higgins, are the most remarkable, indefatigable women, I think, some of the most remarkable, indefatigable women Australia has ever seen. And they are triggering that change. I do not think that Morrison has proved himself in the last year that his menacing approach and his controlling approach is to control the narrative in his favour rather than actually listening, and actually affecting and implementing real change. You know, real change has got to be more than announcements and more than speeches. He attempted a mea culpa speech early on in the piece, and he had to consult his wife to know how to behave to a woman who had allegedly suffered the most heinous of crimes. So it's just extraordinary what we've seen in the last year. And despite his attitude and his response to it, the message is loud and clear that 2021 isn't going to fade into the background. And I believe today marks the very important fact that we're not going away. We are going to continue to demand change.
Grace and Brittany are delivering a joint address at the National Press Club this afternoon, and we're all waiting for it, which is why you're in Canberra yourself. How are they? Can you give us a teaser of that, maybe?
Well, I haven't spoken to either of them this morning, but as we know and as we've seen, they are both incredibly remarkable, articulate, extraordinarily courageous women. And I think that's why the whole country is looking forward to this. I believe the government, again, you know, it's got to be more than a coincidence that the sorry statement was made yesterday, whether that was to take the oxygen out of this statement. I don't think anything can take the oxygen out of the address we're about to see here today in Canberra. I think it's going to rock the country.
Do we know whether or not the Prime Minister himself, Scott Morrison, will be at that address today?
Well, apparently, I read this morning he's said he'll be too busy, which, again, is just a reflection of his attitude and his behaviour all throughout 2021 with regard to any issue relating to the respect, safety and equity for women in this country, not just in Parliament, but across the country. And again, I reiterate, one of the most significant legal reforms that could have been made was the original Respect at Work submission. It was 900 pages long that Kate Jenkins prepared, and the key reform in that was to impose a positive duty on the employer to create a safe and healthy workplace for women with regard to sexual harassment. They put that under the carpet. They didn't implement it. It would have been such significant law reform, just like the occupational health and safety reforms were introduced many years ago, which, you know, really made the number of deaths and safety accidents in the workplace decline. The positive duty on the employer in relation to this issue would have been an amazing reform. But nonetheless, we've seen inaction, including on that.
Jeez, you could find half an hour to turn up to the National Press Club today, that's for sure. Julia Banks, you've got a new book. It is called Power Play. It is a memoir and it is out now, getting lots of great reviews. Julia Banks, we are looking forward to the National Press Club speech by Grace Tame and Brittany Higgins later today. Thank you so much for your insights this morning.
Yeah. Thanks so much, Sarah. Thank you. Thanks, Sarah. Thanks, Tristan. Great to be with you.